And it's actually a utility that allows you to grab videos not from just YouTube, but from many sources. This is basically the clone of Winamp. It's gonna load me the Windows 95 of that era. Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're actually going to talk about Homebrew once again. And the Homebrew is the package manager for the Mac OS and Linux. Actually, I didn't know that it exists for Linux, but it also exists for Linux, which is cool. We're going to discuss about that one. I actually already had a video about the Homebrew and other package managers available for macOS. And I mean, those days, I know it's kind of different because Apple migrated to Apple Silicon and some of the options are not available anymore, but who knows? I mean, so Homebrew is like the default number one package manager for macOS, and it's really easy to install. You just run this one in the command line and it just works. I mean, you just install it and you're ready to install any packages. How to install packages? It's really easy. So you type the name of the package right here, Midnight Commander, my favorite file manager, and it provides you information how to install this one, right? So basically brew install Midnight Commander. You can copy this one and just basically paste it here in terminal and install the package that you like. And today we're actually going to discuss the packages that I especially like. So the first one, of course, is a Midnight Commander. And it's totally up to you if you like those kind of file managers. Of course, you feel free to explore and see other options available for macOS. That's the first one. The second option that I especially like is an HTOP. So HTOP basically shows you the list of processes running in your system right now. It's really easy to use, and I mean, I personally like it. It just like gives you a perspective and idea what's going on in your system. It's like really nice. By the way, to see the list of all applications that were installed on your system, you can just run this command, brew list, and it's gonna show you the list of all the applications installed right now. So as you can see, all the applications I have right now on my system, and we're actually gonna discuss a few of those. Now, the interesting fact about Homebrew that you can basically install not only like utilities, like command line utilities, but you can also install the applications, like actually like applications with a UI. For example, I just installed Chromium. If I type Chromium like this, I can just start the Chromium browser like easily. Chromium, guys, is basically what Google Chrome is based on. Just basically the open source versions of Google Chrome without all the Google stuff. So some people might like it. The version that is basically shipped with this one, I think it's a nightly version, so it might be a little bit unstable because it's a developer build. I mean, it's really nice that it actually doesn't have any Google stuff in it here. So, I mean, it should be more secure, I guess, in that sense. But at the same time, it's probably kind of experimental, so it's up to you if you want to use it. Another thing that I installed that I especially like is gedit, and I actually showed this in my previous videos as well. So the gedit is basically a simple text editor that is shipped with GNOME. And I mean, it's really nice. I mean, it's really popular in for the Linux users, but for the Mac, I mean, it looks kind of strange because, like, for example, when you close the window, it shows this really, really strange kind of dialogue. Like, the UI is really strange for the Mac. But still, you can use this one on your Mac system, which is cool. Another thing that I discovered just today, actually, this is the Reamp application I installed using Homebrew. And this is, guys, basically like a clone of Winamp. I mean, if you're a Windows user, you for sure know what Winamp is, right? So this is basically the clone of Winamp, written completely in Swift language. It's like Winamp in 21st century, but it still has all the classic UI, and you can actually install the skins right here. So you can actually customize it the way you want, but it's really nice. I mean, I just like it. Another thing that I actually want to show you today is the Windows 95. You can actually also install it using the Homebrew. So just check this out. Windows 95 is actually the package that somebody have created, basically it's Windows 95 running in the JavaScript kind of environment. So it's really strange, but at the same time, it's kind of cool. I mean, you can run all your Windows 9X applications right here, but it's quite unstable. I mean, guys, let's try this out. For example, I'm gonna reset the state right now, and I'm gonna press boot from scratch. So it's basically gonna load me the Windows 95 of that era and some applications as well. So let's see how it works. And here it is, guys, basically Windows 95 running in a separate window in some kind of JavaScript kind of environment. And you can use it like the way you use Windows 95. You can install some apps, but I found it's a bit unstable. It just crashes sometimes, quite frequently, actually. So yeah, I mean, it's not the best solution probably, but it just gives you perspective if you want to just like try out how it was like back in the 90s and stuff like this. So yeah, I mean, it's kind of retro stuff right here. You press the escape key and you can just close this window and boom, you're done. Another utility that I especially actually like is this one. It's called YouGet, and it's actually a utility that allows you to grab videos not from just YouTube but from many sources. So you can just like provide the URL right here, and I tried this with this one with the Instagram, and it actually downloads the media from the Instagram, like videos or photos. It's kind of cool. I mean, it's nice. This one is a great utility that you can try, and of course you install it like this way: brew install YouGet. This is how you get it, guys. Very easy. I mean, all the simple syntax right here, and it just works. Let's install some utility. For example, if you type brew install speed test CLI, basically this one is a speed test in the command line. Basically, whatever you run on the website, you can just use the CLI utility to basically run this kind of speed test right here. It's very easy. I think it's very convenient. All right, guys, so it was installed, and we just run it like this: speed test CLI. Well, I've got the firewall alert that is basically trying to access the internet connection, which is fine, great. I actually recommend this firewall Lulu, really great firewall for macOS system, and it's free. All right, so it basically displays all the speeds right here. It's very easy, very convenient. You don't need to actually open the browser window at all. It just works. Another utility that I want to show you is this one. It's called links. For example, if we type this website, like this is like a Russian website, a Russian like search engine, and if you type it, this is just like an example. So it basically allows you, instead of going to the specific website, you can just grab all the text and links, and you can see it like this, in this way. I mean, it's kind of like 90s kind of internet, where like there were no images and just like mostly text and links, and you can explore the website like this. I mean, not the best way in some sense, but in other sense you can, like, for example, read books this way. You can just open specific links and you can just see text without any distractions, which is kind of cool. You can also use this syntax like brew search, and for example brew search MC, and it's gonna provide you information about a specific package. So right now it's actually gonna show me the, like, alright, MC is a midnight commander, and here are the options that you can use to install this one. So it says those. It just lists so many packages, like whatever has MC there. Tomcat, for example, MC edit, MC gimp, MC creator. But where's the midnight commander? I actually don't see it right here, so I probably need to type it like this: midnight commander. And this way it's actually gonna find the specific package. So I mean, the search is probably not ideal. It mostly searched by the package name, right? It searched by the package name, but not at the it doesn't look at the description, stuff like this. I mean, it's not ideal, but it works. So you can use this brew system, homebrew system, to basically install packages on your Mac, and it's really, really convenient. And I just love this option. I mean, it's really great. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. There'll be more videos, and I hope it was entertaining and fun to watch. So yeah, if you like this video, please press the like button and consider subscribing. It's gonna be great. Thank you guys. Bye.